Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to XCOM 2 in our Commander playthrough. We're going on Operation Sky Tower, where we're gonna hack another hidden resistance computer. On that mission, we're gonna take two snipers for once, two sharpshooters, so Cedric is back on board, Vinny, and then Christophe, our ranger, Hugh, our specialist for this mission, and then Ulrich and Yang are grenadiers. Hopefully this will all go well, and here we go. So a successful mission would get us an engineer and would block the guaranteed reinforcements on all guerrilla operations. Not that that is such a big problem, reinforcements on guerrilla operations, but it's more for the engineer that I'm doing this.
Trying to impress the resistance found a way into the Advent network through an access point near our AO. From the looks of it, she found something critical tied to the aliens' latest operation. Unfortunately, she only lived long enough to recover a fragment of the data. We're moving to secure the area, eliminate any alien forces nearby, and hack that terminal before they manage to lock it down. We need that data if we're going to stop their progress.
There we go. I think this is the first one we have of this kind of mission. So it still amounts to hacking something, but the idea behind it is a bit different. So we need to hack a friendly computer this time that recovered some data from the Advent network. There we go.
Five. This is Avenger. The access point we're after is just ahead. Move to secure the area. Expect hostile resistance.
Looks pretty accessible from a distance, so Hugh might be able to hack that thing even from this distance. I'm not gonna consider cover for now. The reason why reinforcements aren't that bad of a thing is because reinforcements are only guaranteed on guerrilla operations, and we usually only have one guerrilla op per month. That means we actually only have one mission that will have reinforcements on them. Let's move further. Seems to be one of those security poles over there.
I get a weird feeling about this place.
You get a weird feeling about this place. That is something you don't normally say.
This thing looks ready to smash something.
Is that an environment suit? Maybe something that can't handle our atmosphere?
Those emissions could be toxic. I advise caution, Commander.
There we go. I expected this much. Because the Shadow Chamber already mentioned that there was a new enemy type. And this thing is an Andromedon. Which is... it's an alien inside of a suit. So for now, it's still an organic unit because it's not because it's being, well, piloted by an organic alien. You can even move him, see him move inside of there. But that's the guy we need to especially take out. I might actually, if they stay on top of the bridge, I might be able to toss a grenade on top of the bridge, causing it to collapse in the next turn. Let's put Cedric over there. And move everybody up, just like we're doing right now. There we go. And let's see what they're doing. If they drop down... no, they don't. Okay. So then I think I'm gonna just lob a grenade over there. I do want to get Cedric in a better position. I can grapple from here. Would that be too close? Might actually spot something else from over here, because it looks like there is something over there as well. But if I just let him grapple over here, that shouldn't trigger anything else, I think. Because there's just civilians down there, which is fine. And then, ooh, might actually be a very good idea to use kill zone, because I have been using kill zone wrong. I know that. So I should aim it at them, set up the kill zone like that, so that's three shots and I have three shots in a mag, and then use a grenade to trigger them and they will move at that point. So let's try this. Okay, and now it's a bit of a dangerous position on that truck, but I think, oh yeah, I can put Ulrich over here next to the pole.
Look at us.
The lantern, whatever you want. Okay, so that's good. No extra triggers. Now let's use a grenade and lob that on top of the... Can I reach? I can reach. Come on. I saw it. Yeah, there we go. So that's what I want to do. If they drop down, that would be ideal. But if they don't, well, then I have a nice shot with the kill zone set up. So here we go. Yes, that's for you indeed. Ulrich, kill him! Kill him! Bam! Okay, so it didn't destroy the bridge itself, but... Hopefully that kills the two Vipers with the kill zone. Hello. Jesus. There we go, that's one shot. Blam! 6 damage. So he still has 2 armor, because that thing starts off with a whopping 4 armor. Okay, so he's taking cover, and then the Viper... Wait, what? Cedric, thank you. Thank you. Okay, why didn't you shoot at the other Viper? And goodbye. So that's one Viper taken care of.
You know that was good.
Yes, that was pretty good. Yang would be ideal if she could remove the last of the... Yeah, the last of the armor over there. Let's put Vinny over here.
Whatever you say.
Hopefully not triggering anything else. Nope, okay. And then let's try a lightning hands at the Viper. Ooh, yes. Thank you. Thank you very much. So that's 2 Vipers down. Now we still need to deal with the Andromedon. Are we gonna do this? I want to check out that pole while we're at it. So if I can hack that thing, that would be nice. Otherwise, I'm just going to probably just blow it up. There we go. Disorient enemies for 2 turns. Reduce enemy will by 50%. That's not really something I want to do. Don't really have any benefits from that. So let's just not do that. And maybe try a grenade to blow up the pole and his cover with it. We don't have a grenade, but Yang does. Do want to be careful that I don't use too many grenades over here. Let's put her over there. No, it's dangerous with the truck over there, but it's the best I can do for now. I'm not going to blow up that full cover behind him, because I want to keep a bit of cover alive here. There we go. So that should shred his remaining armor and allow somebody else to finish him off. There we go. 4 damage. Hugh, can you perform the killing blow for me, please? Oh, I do want to... Oh, yeah. Over there. Okay, so we still have... 3 shots, so that should work out. 74, that's not even gonna kill him. Jesus Christ. Okay then, yeah. And he even misses. He even misses. Okay. I'm gonna have to be careful about this thing now. The annoying thing about an Andromedon is something you'll see in a minute. Because I can't kill it, that's not the problem. It's what it does after it's killed that's the problem. That's only 3-6, so I won't be able to kill it right then and there. But what I can do is use the beacon. That's early. That's really, really early. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to use the beacon, because that is annoying. So let's put the beacon... right in, maybe over here. Put the beacon over here. There we go. Yeah, that spotted you. And then let's put Vinny on Overwatch. Because he's going to move over there. Or not. Did he just figure that out? That was... Oh, that is annoying. So he could technically kill him, but 74 is still a lot. Does Cedric have a shot? He does. I'm gonna try a pistol shot first. Because if I can take him out Well, it's not gonna be taken out, but yeah, there we go. I think that's enough damage to let somebody else get another shot in. So Hugh, or maybe I should just use Cedric as well with the normal sniper shot. Yeah, 100%. There we go. There we go. And the alien is thrown out of the suit. There we go.
I find something here.
And now there's loot, but it sadly comes back to life.
That thing go down. Now what the hell is it doing?
So the suit is automated, which means that if the pilot dies, as it just did, it just comes back to life with a bit more health. And yeah, so that's why I didn't want to take it out in the previous turn. Let's see what we can do, because now it is a mechanical unit. So if I check out my pistol shots, these are amazing. So I'm going to fire the pistol twice because I have the quick draw ability. And just take care of that guy with the pistol, because and hack defense increase, because now I can actually hack it as well, which might actually be, you know what, that might actually be not a bad idea. Oh no, I don't have a combat hacker with me. Never mind, pistol shot it is. Pistol shot it is. Goodbye, Armageddon? No, Andromedon. So yeah, pretty hard to deal with. But we did it nonetheless. So let's see. There's loot over there, but I do have to be careful now. Because we only have 6 turns left because of that distraction, kind of. And we still need to get to that access point. Stupid thing is that I just used my, my beacon, my mimic beacon. So if anything happens along the way that I can't beat... Oh, shit. There we go. Or maybe that's just for the animation. I couldn't move. Lyrium core, U2 Lyrium cores, and a superior expanded magazine, which is really good. Okay. You have the package, which is good. Vinny can't do anything, so I'm just going to move... Ulrich up. Oh, goddammit. Yeah. He triggered something. Okay. That's gonna be a problem. Because they get a turn to move closer, and even then I don't have... Shit. I could try running gun. I could try that. I'm gonna do that just to have a shot.
Seems doable.
Because I think I should be able to shoot at... Oh, 25. That is terrible, but nevertheless, miss, probably, yeah. Okay. Thought that would be a flank shot, but it's probably one row further, one column further. How far does that reach? I could do that. But I don't really have a good position for her. Hugh, put yourself... officers have grenades, though. I'm gonna put him inside of the building. Over here. There we go, pretty safe. And then... Yang, how far can you go? No. She can't go inside of the building, sadly. Well, just that one slot, but that means she doesn't have any cover. I think I'm gonna just have to put her pretty close to the building. Oh, that cover did blow up. That is... Because I kept that over here for just that reason. God damn it, that would have been better. Yeah, I'm gonna put her over here and see what happens. He can't go on Overwatch anymore. But I could put him over here. Let's try that.
No problem, boss.
Spread them out a bit and then use the incendiary bomb. How far can I get that? Yeah, okay. So that's pretty good. So fire damage on both the officer and the shield bear. Maybe killing one because of the fire damage. Don't think that will happen, but
grenade out.
It's a chance I'm going to have to take. Here we go. So, 2 out of 3 armor shredded and a bit of damage on both. It's not gonna kill them though.
Retreat.
So now they're... Yeah, that's 3 damage on him and then 3 or 2 on the other guy. That is one hell of an inferno, by the way. Can that car still explode? Because that would be nice. So the officer is freaking out. He has probably a flanking shot. Oh. He's marking Cedric for some reason. That's probably the worst shot he could get. That's a flank shot, probably. Oh. That's the first time we've seen that happen. So the shield bearer activated the shields. And then the mech is, of course, immune to burn damage. He's going to fire at Yang. Oh, and he misses. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Yeah, that was very close. And that's it. Oh, I thought the officer would have another shot, but apparently not. That is good, because... Vinny, do you have sight on the mech? Yeah, you do. That's really good. So I can take out the mech if I want to. But I do have to be... Ooh. I could try and skulljack the officer. So let's try that first. I'm going to skulljack the officer with... Skull mine in this case with the hue. Is that full cover? Looks like it should be full cover. And skull mine. 70% chance. And there we go. That was nice. That was very nice. So minor cache of enemy intel. I'm gonna take that. Ooh, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Very well. Nicely done, you. Nicely done. So that's the officer taken care of through his shields. I don't care for one bit. And now he's in full cover. So that's exactly how I wanted it to go. So that shield effectively adds 5 health to everyone. Unless we can take out the shield bearer, which drops the shields on everybody else, obviously. So let's put Yang a bit closer, preferably over here, because we're starting to run out of time. Could shoot at the mech, could shoot less at the shield bearer. Can I destroy his cover? Ulrich, my man. I know you can do this. You're no longer in a flanked position if I put you over there, so let's go over there. Gotta be careful, because there are still more enemies on the map. This is not everything we have. And if I use the grenade now, I might not be able to use it later. And I think those supports, because their supports for the bridge are indestructible. So he picked a nice spot to hunker down there. You know what? I'm gonna not use a grenade. How are your shots, actually? 32, so that shield bear is really hunkered down there. Can't do anything with Christoph because I use run and gun already. I can take out the mech. I'm pretty sure I can take out the mech if I want to. But the shield bearer is in a tougher position. I could actually get a shot in from here. 70% is not that bad. Because his aim has gone through the roof with that. Ooh, 5 damage. That's really good. So that's the entire shield if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. So there goes his shield. Now... If I'm able to hit one of these low percentage chances, because they're really low percentage chances, I'm not having any illusions about that, but if I could hit one of them, that would be awesome.
Whatever you say.
Ulrich, maybe you should try first, because I think you have the highest chance, even if it's only 32. Was that a hit? Oh, a miss. Yeah, okay. 1 damage because of the stalk. Okay. Sadly, I don't have stocks on everybody, but I think she might actually have a stock. 23% chance. That really low. That's really, really low. Oh, wow. Whoa. What?
That's right.
Yeah, that's right, apparently. I actually want to... Oh, no. I used Hugh already. Do I use pistol shots? 73. I think I should, right? Because there's 8 to... So 8 will not kill him. I'm just gonna try, but 11 might. There we go. 10 is enough. Goodbye, back.
Impressed yet?
So that's the last one of those. And now I'm gonna move Vinny a bit further. Because we're probably getting pretty close to where we need to be. Let's just put Christoph over there. I think he's the last one, so that's why I can't move my cursor. You're not gonna spawn any more enemies, thank you. Hugh, if I put you over here, can you see the laptop already? Oh, he can.
We have confirmation of the exposed access point.
So we could already do that now, because I actually, if there's no enemies here, I should actually just do that. So I won't waste a turn on hacking that when there's actually enemies in sight. There we go. Delays dark event projects by 2 weeks. Research time on the current tech reduced by 50%. There's no negative effect to this. And we are researching plated armor, I think. Although delaying the dark events by 2 weeks is not that bad. And I get that guaranteed. But you know what? Let's just... What was in the dark events? You know what? I'm just gonna go for the sure thing and delay the dark events. Good luck I did, because we wouldn't have gotten inside. There we go. 39 is just way too low.
C'est bon.
So that's the objective completed.
Successful acquisition of the Advent file.
It sounds like there's a mech inside of the building, so... I'm just gonna put everybody I can on Overwatch and move... Do I move Cedric up already? I'm just gonna move him a bit. Just to the middle of the bridge. So he doesn't trigger anything. Yeah, there they are. Another Andromedon. Oh, Jesus Christ. So 9 enemies and 2 of them were Andromedon. Oh, thank you very much. That's nice damage. 6. And a pistol shot. That missed the Lancer, I think.
Come on, focus!
Yeah, focus indeed. So, Andromedon. Again, so... If I can keep... Vinny as the last one, I can take out the suit. How far can we get that grenade in? Because I can't... Are they positioned perfectly so I can't... Looks like they are. I could take out the Andromedon and the side of the building. Sadly, not the cover of the Lancer, but that's something I'm going to be able to live with, I think. So, Ulrich! Use your, I would say your last grenade, but we've been saving them pretty conservatively. And take out a bit of that armor. And now he's wide out in the open. We just need to make sure that we kill everybody else as well. So, Yang. Let's put you in here.
On my way.
And then Cedric. Cedric might actually have... Oh, he has a lightning shot still in his arsenal. So let's put you over here.
Seems doable.
There we go. And then use lightning hands on the heavy lancer, killing him immediately. Thank you very much. Goodbye. That's one less problem. And then I still have a turn, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, there we go. Promotion earned. That might be his last promotion as well. And use his grenade on the... Oh no, don't tell me. Oh, seriously? There goes my plan. Well then. Just gonna use Yang to fire at the Andromedon, hopefully hitting and shredding his armor. So that would be very, very nice if she did that. Yes! And it even killed him! That was a critical! Well, killed him. Kind of killed him. So there we go, that's not a problem, because I can take care of that with Vinny. And I think, yeah, I have run and gun back, so I can actually try and take out the trooper from close by as well. But first, not with my butt first, but... So I could just try and fire at the Andromedon shell, but that won't kill it. So I think I'm gonna have to do the risky thing and put Vinny out in the open. We know he can hit them from over here. Although that's full cover. It's gonna block his sight, so I'm just gonna put you right next to Yang.
Whatever you say.
And hoping that you can actually see the Andromedon. Okay. 78 is not perfect, by the way. That might actually pan out really, really badly. Oh shit, what did I do? God damn it. Shit. I didn't do lightning reflexes. And I can't probably select them anymore. No, fuck. That is annoying. Because we still have two enemies we need to take care of. But the trooper isn't that bad. So if I can put his stuff close enough for a nice shotgun shot.
Ass.
So let's put him on running gun and put him over here.
Affirmative.
That should get him close. Far enough from the trooper and close enough to the Andromedon. Hello? Yeah, okay. 100%. So that should kill him. That should kill him. Oh god, thank you. 13 damage with the storm gun.
You know that was
and now he has implacable, if I'm not mistaken. So I'm gonna put him just behind this full
whatever
cover. And then put Cedric. Oh. I can actually fire at the trooper from over here. And it's a pistol shot, so why not? That's 3 damage. And then do we have... I think we have Hugh left, no? Yeah, we still have Hugh left. If I put him over there, he should be able to fire one more time. Chances are big that the trooper will survive this and he's going to fire at one of us. But he's not going to be able to kill anybody. That was a hit. It didn't kill him. I think he has 1 health left. Or 2. 2. Okay. Are you going to... What is he doing? That's not a... Yeah, that would be... He just fired at the furthest guy from him. Oh, because he's out in the open. Right, okay, so yeah, he doesn't have any cover. That was kind of lucky that he didn't get hit there. Hugh, I think you're the perfect candidate to finish this off. Because there's a door here. Or is... That's not a door. That's not a door. I thought that was a door. It's not a door. Well, you know what, just go over there and then fire your gun at him. 70% should work. Yeah, bye. Thank you, Hugh. Does that give you a promotion? Because I would really like to have another promotion on you. Please? No?
All hostiles are down and the area is secure.
That was pretty nicely done. Flawless. 11 out of 11 with 2 Andromedon. Wait a second. The shadow... What? The shadow... I thought something was wrong. The shadow chamber said... Oh no, the shadow chamber said 9 enemies, but the Andromedon counts as 2 because you need to defeat him twice. Never mind. Shadow chamber is a tough word for me for some reason. Shadow chamber. Yes. Well, I'm calling myself the babbling Belgian for something, right? So, Vinny dealt most damage with his EMP rounds. Yang made most attacks, but was under fire the most as well. And Christoph, as always, our runner, moved the furthest. He's been doing that a lot lately. Did I actually? No, I gave Jazz the extra movement, probably, I think. Yeah, I gave that to Jazz because of the sword attacks. So let's see. I think we got a few promotions out of that.
I never had any doubts about your capabilities, 2. Commander. Excellent work as always.
Okay then. Yang. Heavy ordnance or holo targeting? Holo targeting is really, really good, but it can't hold the candle to heavy ordnance where we get another grenade. So I always go for heavy ordnance because that's honestly the best option. So heavy ordnance, the grenade in your grenade only slot gains a bonus use. And then we have Cedric. Is he? No, almost. So steady hands. If you did not move last turn, gain 10 aim and 10 critical chance. Or aim. Hunker down now confers 20 aim to the first shot on the following turn. Does he have... He has deep cover, which is interesting. I think I'm just going to go for steady hands. Is that something that will be active most of the time? Hunkering down... Well, requires a bit more action than just a passive buff if you didn't move. Since we're going to probably just put him in a sniper spot as we always do and put him there. So, steady hands it is. There we go. Two promotions in the back. So, Cedric, Hugh and Christophe are one rank away from the last rank. So, two Valerian cores, which is really good. A superior expanded magazine. And the corpses of everything we killed. And then the 20 intel from the hack, which is really, really good as well. Thank you very much. Andromedon Autopsy. The beings that inhabit these suits clearly come from an environment utterly hostile to humans. The corrosive substance they use as a weapon may be the equivalent to water for them, but on this planet it's deadly. I've theorized as to how the substance could somehow be used to our advantage as part of an explosive weapons system.
You have done an outstanding job leading the resistance.
And an extra engineer, and we countered the rapid response. Cedric restored his will and its increase. The soldier recovered. Thank you very much. And new staff acquired Bat Thomas. I think I'm going to put her to excavating the, shielding the power core over here. So let's put her in here. And that should have the time to 15 days probably, yeah. Okay, that's really, really good. I'm 2 days away from powered armor. So that's good that I didn't go for cutting that time down to half. Because that wouldn't probably do anything, by the way. Proving
Picking
up an ground.
Unsecured transmission from some clown calling himself Van Dorn. Doesn't sound like the kind of recruit we're looking for.
Van Dorn is the first VIP you need to rescue in XCOM. It's kind of fixed in XCOM, enemy unknown and enemy within. So it's always Van Dorn. So that's the guy he's talking about. That's a nice Easter egg. Choose project. I think I'm going to go... I don't want to do too much, but with the extra Illyrium course... This is gonna be... Oh, there's one type of grenade I really, really want. And we have pretty much all the ammo types I wanted to have. So I'm just gonna go for another experimental grenade. There it is. Thank you. The acid bomb. The chemical additive in the upgraded acid bomb is extremely corrosive, able to strip away most enemy armor immediately while continuing to damage the target over time with chemical burns. So that's... I feel like this is the most powerful grenade of the mole, because nobody is immune to acid and it removes any armor. You can't block the armor loss, and it's also something that the Andromedan can use to attack, by the way, acid, because we haven't seen that before. But it's also damage over time, but the benefit of it is that it burns off armor immediately. So that's gonna become really, really powerful, because that was the reason why I went for all those experimental grenades. Okay, so that's pretty much what I wanted to have. Do we have any more items we need to make, I wonder?
What can I do for you, Commander?
Because I think we still have the plasma rifle that we need to upgrade, but we don't have that many supplies left after that, so I'm just gonna wait and see what happens on the bridge.
It must have been pretty cushy working with Advent.
I wonder why they do that. They put in dialogue when I push the button to go immediately to the bridge, but they cut them off if you go into the bridge. So that's weird. So that's supplies. I think we don't have anything else at the moment. And I'm still in the process of... You know what? That might actually be a good idea. I am going to upgrade the resistance communications, but that allows us to contact two more regions, if I'm not mistaken. I do need to put an engineer in here, which sucks, but yeah, I think this is just... Although, you know what, I'm just gonna wait a bit and just go for those supplies and then do that so we can get more contacts after that. Because I want to make contact with New India and then put another radio tower over there. So then we get the quid pro quo, which reduces the cost of all black market items with 33%. But. Supplies.
Avenger,
battlefield supplies.
New course.
We're still pretty good on Avatar Project progress. We're close to getting the Shadow Chamber up and running. which is going to be in 2 days when we get the powered armor. And that's also something I want to keep my supplies for.
I have made
there
a
we
number
go.
Of interesting discoveries.
Kind of forgot about that, but powered armor is more important than the one or two guys that are going to be able to shoot the plasma rifle. So assign... I'm not going to assign new research, but I'm just going to go over there so I can get the explanation here. From what we've seen of the aliens' activities and their lack of regard for human life, preserving those of us that are still around has to become a task of equal importance to eliminating the alien threat itself. The success of this entire undertaking hinges on our ability to keep our soldiers healthy and ready for battle at a moment's notice. In working towards that aim, our latest armor prototype utilizes more of the alien alloys than any we've previously assembled. And as expected, the durability and potential for damage mitigation is extremely impressive. Initial trials show the armor to be capable of withstanding a direct hit from focused plasma at 5 meters, enough so to increase survivability by a substantial margin. I plan on advising the senior staff not to inform the troops of any perceived toughness associated with the suit. I would hate for our forces to grow reliant on it despite our best intentions. That's of course very good advice, because even though the armor is better, we still need to be careful, of course. So, new item available, the Warden Armor, new Proving Ground Project, Wraith Suit, and the War Suit. So those are actually two suits I never made in my original playthrough, but I want to do that in this one. So the Warden Armor, our new mastery of the aliens' Illyrium technology has led us to the ultimate in battle armor, the Warden Armor. Illyrium powered armor provides unprecedented survivability and versatility in the battle against increasingly powerful alien enemies. And then the War Suit, by harnessing the power of Illyrium, it may be possible to create a new heavy powered armor suit capable of generating a defensive force field, not unlike those used on the alien craft. And then the Wraith Suit, having seen the aliens manipulating psionic fields for a variety of purposes, we've theorized it may be possible to traverse through the physical confines of our world. Of our world, probably. By developing a psionic field enmeshed in a specially designed light armor suit. So, this suit can actually make you temporarily invincible, because you're... well, untouchable. You can't attack as well, because you're going in sort of a different dimension. But it's really good for scouting units as well. So that's the Wraith Suit. And then the Shield Bearer Autopsy, I can do that instantly, so I'm going to do that in a second. Right now.
Physically, the Advent Shield Bearers are quite similar to the bulk of Advent's forces, in that they are the product of careful genetic engineering that generally mirrors the human form. Most of their unique qualities come from a difference in equipment and armor. Components I'm sure Shen would have an interest in examining.
There we go.
The are not all that dissimilar from their various Advent peers. Their armor is perhaps the most distinctive feature differentiating them.
So, new Proven Ground Project experimental armor. As is usually the case, our troops came up with a designation for this particular subject, currently known as the Shield Bear. Initial indications are that it is tactically on par with Advent's other humanoid field units, with no particular mental or physical advantages over the officers or other units. The primary difference seems to lie in the armor suit itself, which is heavily reinforced with multiple layers of composite material woven from what I can only surmise to be some variation of the alien alloys. I intend on leaving the metallurgy and structural analysis to Shen and her team, who will no doubt find a means of integrating her findings into various experimental armor concepts of our own. Thank you, Kagan. So, our autopsy of the Advent Shieldbearer gave us some ideas regarding new vest designs that, by incorporating recovered Illyrium cores, could increase soldier survivability in dramatic fashion. So that just adds another project track for the Proving Grounds, in which we can make different suits of body armor, so the underlying vests. I'm going to show you that in a minute, but now we're going to go to the Shadow Chamber. I'm going to leave anyway, because we're going to activate some research in the Shadow Chamber.
When it came to handling the interrogation and autopsy of alien subjects. From what I've heard, she was keen to get her hands dirty whenever possible.
Yeah, Valen was a bit of a naughty girl when it came to aliens. She likes to she liked to torture them a bit. Change Shadow Project. So what are we gonna do first? I think we're gonna go for the Codex Brain first, because I think that loosens the Avatar Project even further, so it reduces the their progress. Let's see what we can do with that. So all research projects will be suspended. That is true. So let's accept that for days. What else do we have? We need to go to engineering. and see how much that armor costs, because I do want to get that. Weapons and armor. One armor. We can buy that immediately, but of course it's 300 supplies, 40 alloys, and 20 crystals. I think I'm just going to do that. That's a squad upgrade for everybody. So everybody's going to benefit from that. Aside maybe from Cedric, since I probably going to keep the spider suit on him. But here we go.
This is our basic power armor frame, providing the durability you'd expect from a giant armored suit.
There we go, and Benito showcasing it off. Look at that thing. So that is the Warden armor, so the last armor upgrade we're gonna do, because we can't do anything else. So we're running pretty low on supplies now, but I do want to check out the Proving Ground. So is that armor, I'm wondering, is that armor free? Experimental armor? Looks like just one Illyrium core, but I can't complete it instantly as I can the grenades and ammo because of the perk we got. So the suits cost actually supplies as well, so that's why we can't actually make one of those. Because otherwise I would have made one of those war suits, because they're really, really cool. They look extremely cool. But maybe there's no engineer inside of this room for now, but I think I can fix that immediately. So I'm gonna put in experimental armor.
Good,
there we go.
I'll let you know as soon as the project is ready for deployment.
And then get out quickly. Well, not that quickly, but I'm gonna remove one of the gremlins in the power station, because we have enough power for now, and then add the gremlin in the engineer slot, reducing that to 6 days instead of 12. Okay, I think that's pretty much all we could do for now, so let's go back to the bridge.
Isn't bad, considering.
Why do you start that when I press triangle? I want to get everybody to listen to that, but if you just start talking when I go to the bridge, you're going to get cut off anyway. But supplies. We need supplies. We really, really need supplies. I think the shadow chamber will probably complete before we get the supplies. Yeah, there we go.
Piecing this thing back together, but it hasn't been pretty.
Our soldiers completely disabled this unit in the field. What we're hearing is merely a byproduct of electrical impulses. I assure you, it is well past the point of feeling pain.
I'll take your word for it, Doctor.
I'm sending you a new sequence now.
These are coordinates. Return coordinates. I think we've got a point of origin. Well, part of one. Something,
that looks like a pretty good position to me.
Underneath.
One more.
Guys?
Something to block further access.
So I think it is active.
I'm losing the data we've already decrypted.
Almost there. Just one more adjustment.
Please don't blow up the ship, guys.
It's accessing the power core. Overriding my safety. Increasing power levels to Titan. Sever the connection.
There.
Boom. There goes the shadow chamber.
Some sort of fail-safe protocol, I imagine. The Codex must have intentionally overloaded the interface to prevent any further theft of information. Still, I believe I was one step ahead of it.
That's an enormous amount of data.
Yes, and I expect it may take some time to decipher.
Well done, Tigan. Well done.
I don't think we're going to be able to do that again.
I'll proceed with the necessary research and preparation. With your approval, of course, Commander. I'd also suggest we look into those coordinates.
That's if I can reconstruct the data we lost in the transfer. I just hope it was worth it.
I think it was, guys. I think it was. Because, yeah, we're moving forward with the story now. So, completed the encrypted Codex data shadow project. So, now we need to decrypt that in the shadow chamber as well.
You are, Commander. I've updated our objectives based on the latest information.
In the field, the Codex appears as an anomalous form in an almost constant state of flux, seemingly only present in our world for milliseconds at a time. However, it was apparently not immune to the effects of conventional weaponry, having dissipated before leaving behind this object.
The Codex itself is a remarkable entity, all beyond of expectation of what a sentient biological organism could or should be. Our limited exposure to it leaves a number of open questions, and as it appears to phase or flux out of our visible spectrum, it will undoubtedly prove to be a difficult specimen to study. In any case, our troops were able to recover what can only be described as a Codex brain, a central processing unit encompassing data storage, communications, tactical control, as well as a host of other functions we've yet to identify. With the Shadow Chamber in place, Shen and I conducted a thorough, albeit difficult, series of experiments to unravel the mysteries of the device. Through a series of high-frequency exposures, we were successful in forcing the Codex to reveal itself beyond the confines of the brain alone. Shen expressed varying concerns about the well-being of the Codex, as it appeared to be responding and even resisting our efforts to decrypt the data and access the Advent network. I assured her any indication of pain or active intolerance of our testing was merely a byproduct of the procedure. Before the Codex destroyed itself, along with our containment area, we did manage to recover a subset of the data containing what appears to be a set of map coordinates. It'll take more time to work through the remaining fragments, but in the interim, we have a lead to pursue. Thank you, Tigans. That was a pretty big explanation. So who's gonna fix this mess, by the way? Because the glass is completely shattered, but there's a few things we can do. I could change the Shadow Project to the new thingy. The vial, probably. The vial or the encrypted Codex data. I do have extra research, apparently. What's this? Is that just because I don't have any new research? Commander. Yeah, okay, so I don't have any new research set, and that's why it's complaining. I think it's better that we just push through with the story for now. So leave anyway, because we're still, I don't want to risk us hanging out to dry here when we're getting close to the end of the Avatar project again. So let's check the black side file as well, because that will allow us to get another set of coordinates, if I'm not mistaken. And if we go back to the bridge, now we actually have another mission, if I'm not mistaken. There we go.
Coordinates Shen and Tigan pulled from the Codex, Commander. But we'll have to make contact with the local resistance cell before we can move to investigate the site.
So that would get us 175 supplies. After making contact with local resistance in the region, investigate the map coordinates recovered from the Codex brain. Okay.
I've updated our latest operational objectives, Commander.
So there we go. We have another mission that would block off the Avatar project, but it's all the way in the south. Not that it's that far, because I can get there from West Africa. And then probably from South Africa, we can head over to New Chile. So that would be nice as well. But we still need to make contact with India as well. So I might do that first, because we can complete Asia then as well. So let's get those supplies first. Thank you very much. In spring of 2015, human military forces engaged one of the first alien battleships in the skies over this area. The civilian populace below was devastated during the ensuing battle. We deployed teams to sweep for possible salvage, and they returned with a number of resources found scattered throughout the area. Thank you very much. And now, I'm done scanning that, so I think I'm just gonna go back and see what we can do here. Let's go to resistance comms. And oh, I can't upgrade that probably. Yeah, we're running out of supplies. Let's go to the bridge again. I think I'm gonna check out how much intel do we have. We have a lot of intel, so I'm just gonna head towards the black market.
Avenger plotting new course.
And see what we can buy over there, because we really would need to upgrade our resistance communications. Let's buy some stuff, and they usually have supplies in trade in exchange for intel. So we're gonna buy those 125 supplies. Don't need anything else for now. So let's just leave and check out the resistance communication building. Well, room. And then upgrade that with one additional station.
Communications facility upgraded.
And now we immediately get another contact, so I don't really need to do anything else. I'm just gonna now start making contact with South Asia, but apparently that's not a thing. So New India. So let's make contact with New India. There we go. 40 intel because we're close to a radio tower and we're just gonna make contact.
Commander, we've utilized all of our available
communication capacity. We know, Shen, we know.
We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
We can without upgrading our systems. I know we can. Oh! Communication from the Resistance. That's interesting. So let's view that. Neutralize a target. 177 supplies and 90 intel. That would be very nice. Elite Officer, Elite Shield Bearer, Advent Mech, Andromedon, and Viper. So mostly mechanical units. So let's launch that.
Course for Sector 14,
and
Asia.
I think it's time that we put Benito back in the squad. Although, we have another specialist that we've got. Oh, look at those guys. Look at those guys. That looks... Well, I should say that it kind of looks sexy, by the way. I love how it's form-fitting like that. Maybe I should just shut up. The other thing that the armor does is it's... Or not. Apparently it doesn't. I thought it gave us another slot, the armor itself, but apparently it didn't really do that. Or maybe if I edit, I get another... Huh. I thought that just added another slot, but apparently not. That is interesting. I'm gonna remove the Skulljack from Hugh and give him another gas bomb. Or do I make him a complete utility guy? So if I give them the give him the flashbang, but the flashbang is just, we have better ways to deal with dangerous situations now. Could go for the, oh no, I know what I'm gonna do. I need to give that expanded magazine to Cedric, but I need to wait until he has a better weapon to do that. I'm gonna remove Cedric then. And then the question is, do I use Emma and just level her up? I think I'm gonna do that because Benito is leveled up completely. So if I put Emma in, Emma is, I think she has, yeah, she has Haywire Protocol and Combat Protocol. So if I load her up with a few nice thingies over here, I'm gonna give the Skulljack to her as well. And then maybe the Plasma Grenade is fine, I think. Magnetic Rifle, can't do anything about that, but I can give her another weapon upgrade. Could give her an Autoloader. Yeah, I'm gonna give her an Autoloader and a Scope, because we have, well, we have a lot of extra... Yeah, we have a lot of extra stuff in here. So that's good. I'm gonna quickly check Christoph's shotgun, because I think the weapon upgrades I can add... No! Am I that mistaken? Because when I originally played this, I think the last weapons, the plasma weapons, added another slot for an upgrade. But apparently it doesn't. That is interesting. Is that a change they did? What? Never mind. We still have an other autoloader, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe I should put that on Vinny here. Yeah, why not? Oh, no, we don't. I just gave the autoloader to Emma. Never mind. 10% chance that a shot will not cost an action. Well, that sounds like something that would be nice as well. Because he's going to fire a lot more than anybody else. So if I can fire a pistol... Now I can fire a pistol 3 times. So if there's a chance, there's a 10% chance that it will not cost an action even. So that would be... He could even fire 4 times then. That would be awesome. Because he really needs to level up. Even though 19 kills and he didn't level up yet. I'm going to give him another grenade as well. There we go. Just a normal grenade. Because he's going to be down on the ground with the rest of the guys. And then that's pretty much it, I think. Because we gave the Skulljack to Emma. Yeah, this is going to be the squad we're going to head out with. So welcome Emma, by the way. Another of the female soldiers that we're going to level up pretty much. So yeah, thank you guys, Domsey, for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, you can like it right here on YouTube. And next time we're going to go on Operation Doombreaker. So thank you guys, Domsey, for watching. And I hope to see you in the next video series. Goodbye.